Hello my dear students, Arshdeep Kaur here. Welcome to my channel. This is physics class for class 10th. Okay, so watch the video till end for the proper understanding of the topic. So our today's topic is expression for work, that is W is equal to Fs cos of theta. Okay, this expression we have to derive. Okay, we have to prove this expression. Okay, so W is the work. Okay, F is the applied force, S is the displacement, and theta is the angle between force and displacements. So students, it is not necessary that the force always causes the displacement of a body in its own direction. So sometime the force displaces the body in the direction other than the direction of a force. Okay, in that cases we need this expression Fs cos of theta. When the displacement and force are in different direction, not in same direction. So let's take an example. You can see the diagram here. This one is an inclined plane. On this inclined plane, the body is placed at point A. Okay, the mass of a body is M. Let it be M, the mass of a body at point A. When we applied the force F, okay, the arrow shows the direction of the force. When we applied the force on A, then the body displaced from A to B. Okay, A to B, and cover the distance S, that is a displacement. So the body move from A to B. Now you can see that here is the direction of the force. Okay, and this one is the direction of a displacement, and the angle between displacement and force is theta. Then question is that how can we find the work done? Okay, so in this case we have two options. Okay, two option. First option, by using component of force, and second by using component of displacement. So one by one we will discuss these two cases. So first case, by using the component of displacement. Okay, so let's start this. So by using component of displacement, now we know that work is equal to force into displacement. Okay, now work is written as W, force is F. Now force and displacement are in same direction, so this S displacement, is in same direction if we take displacement from point A to C, because if I draw the perpendicular from B to this C, this is a perpendicular, this one is a theta, then AB, okay, approximately equal to AC. So in the direction of a force, the displacement is AC. Okay, AC is the displacement in the direction of a force. So we can write it as W is equal to F multiplied by AC. Give it equation number 1. So now our next step is to find this AC. Now how to find this AC? Now we can see this in triangle ACB. Okay, we take triangle ACB. In this triangle, this AC is base of right angle triangle, BC is the perpendicular of the right angle triangle, and AB is the hypotenuse. Okay, so we know the value of AB and we want to find the value of AC. So in triangle ACB, AC divide by AB. Why I do so? Because AC we want to find and value of AB we have, that is a S. Now AC is base and AB is hypotenuse. Now base upon hypotenuse. Now base upon hypotenuse is equal to cos of theta. Cos of theta. So AC is equal to AB cos of theta. Okay. Now the value of AB is S cos of theta. So AC is equal to S cos theta. Now put this equation number 2 in equation number 1. Then we get W is equal to FS cos of theta. FS cos of theta. Okay. And this S cos theta is the component of displacement along the direction of a force. So we can write it as AC is equal to S cos of theta. Now S cos theta and F both are in same direction. We can find out the work done just by multiplying these two. Okay, F and S cos theta. So this one is a work done by using the component of displacement. So next one is the work done by using the component of a force. In component of a force, let's take this diagram again. The body is at point A. By applying this force F, it moves from A to B and covers the displacement S. The angle between F and S is theta. Okay, now I just extend this AB in backward direction. Okay, then these two are the vertically opposite angle. If this angle theta, then this one is also theta. Now this one is a force and I draw the BN perpendicular on this extended line. This one is of 90 degree. Okay, now we want to find the component of a force along displacement. Now the displacement is in the direction A to B, same as the force in direction of this AB is this one, that is NA. We want to find this NA because this force is in the direction of displacement S. This become component of a force F and this become displacement S. Okay, so again work done is equal to, now the force is AN, the force is AN and displacement is S. Give it equation number 1 again. Now we want to find this AN. Okay, now this AN is again base, this AB is force F, this is hypotenuse and this BN is again perpendicular. Okay, so AN is equal to, how to find out? AN in triangle ANB, AN divided by AB, base upon hypotenuse, again cos of theta. So AN is equal to AB cos of theta. Now AB is equal to F cos theta, then AN is equal to F cos theta. Okay, so our work done, W is equal to using 2 in 1 value of AN, then it become F cos theta S, then W is equal to F S cos of theta. Give it to equation number 3. Now equation number 3, W is equal to F cos theta, and our previous equation W is equal to F cos theta. It means the work done remains same. It means whether we take the component of a force or the component of a displacement, the work done is remain same. W is equal to F S cos theta. The cos is the